everything. If you got breath, you ought to praise God. You understand? You know, I thank God for the encouraging words from my brother. He talked about down the street by himself. Well, you know, I started having those moments back when I was about 19 years old. When I received the Holy Ghost. I never forget when I received the Holy Ghost right there in Hartsville, South Carolina. Calling Lord Jesus. You know, back in that day, it wasn't no shame to call. And say what you want about them old times. They encourage you all the Lord. They encourage you all the Lord. We was there, Hartsville, there on the mission of Hunt. And you know, 2 hour prayer back then was a common thing. You say 2 hour prayer today, they think you're crazy. But from 10 a.m. to 12 noon was prayer. Face of God at about 11:55.
All right, come on.
I can give you the time.
Yes, sir.
There was about 5 minutes left in that prayer.
Yes.
If you standing in the pulpit, I was over on the right wing. Calling on the name of the Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You know, it was such a beautiful spirit in the building because everybody was on one accord.
Come on.
When you step in the building, you can hear Lord Jesus.
Yeah.
Lord Jesus. Nobody concerned about who was wearing. Everybody want to call him on the Lord Jesus. I tell folks often, environment, it does make a difference.
Yes, sir.
You understand? It makes a difference. You know, you want to be amongst some believers.
Yeah.
Bible said all that believe were together. In one place, the Bible said Jesus didn't do a whole lot of mighty works and miracles because of the environment. Unbelief. You understand? So it makes a difference.
Yes, sir.
As I was calling on the Lord, about 5 minutes left in the prayer, here comes the Lord. That Holy Ghost got down in me.
Yes, sir.
My mouth came open.
Yes, sir.
I started talking in a language that I did not understand.
Yes.
Let me tell you something. You know, I have heard folk prior to then talking about the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
But now I can tell you about the Holy Ghost.
Right,
because from that day until this day, I've had that moment since he was talking about it. I remember, my God, that same weekend, after that experience, riding down the long country roads in South Carolina by myself, I started having the moments, brother. Just thinking about the Lord. Before you know it, God will move my whole body. Right in the car. You understand? So I can relate to the moments. And let me tell you something. If you haven't had the moments, you need the Holy Ghost. Saints, the Bible said everything to have breath, praise God. Come on up here, twin. Come up here and read a little bit, brother. I like my brother, we ain't gonna hold you long. But I want to show you something. You know, a lot of us come from sophisticated backgrounds. Where we come and we kind of just sit in church and look at one another. We're kind of sophisticated. But you know, but I want to show you something tonight in the scripture. We talked some of this last week because God had been dealing with me about it. And that's crazy. That's crazy. Let me tell you something. He talked about calling on the Lord. And the Lord will come, he'll help. When you call on the Lord will show up. And he's going to help. Now, I want to show you some saints in the book who was in some trouble.
Yeah, come on,
man. I said they was in trouble.
Yeah, they were.
But I want to show you what they're going to do. Second Chronicles, brother, chapter 20. I want you to stay with me in the book. Second Chronicles, chapter 20, twin. And I want you to start at verse 1. What did it say, son?
And it came to pass.
It came to pass?
After this also.
That what?
That the children of Moab and the children of Ammon, and with them on the other side, the Ammonites.
What?
Came against Jehoshaphat's battle.
Listen, though. You got the children of Ammon, Moab, and others coming against Jehoshaphat and Judah. Coming against the people of God. What did it say, son?
Then there came stood in the congregation of Judah.
What did he say?
And Jerusalem.
What did he say?
In the house of the Lord before the new court.
Jehoshaphat that stood before them in the house of the Lord. What happened?
And said.
What did he say?
Oh Lord God of our fathers.
Oh Lord God of our fathers.
Yes, sir.
Can you hear Jehoshaphat?
Yes, sir.
He's crying out to the Lord for help. We can't do nothing with this people. We're crying out to you, God. What did he say, brother?
Oh Lord God of our fathers.
What did he say?
before the wilderness of Jeruel.
Read it, son.
You should not need to fight in this battle.
A whole of you. You ain't got to fight. You don't have to fight. They coming at you, but you ain't got to fight. You ain't got to fight. Hallelujah. What did it say, son?
Set yourself.
Set yourself. What is it, Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
in the church, and you can testify how God brought you out. My God can cast me out the keepers. The Bible says God set an ambush. He ambushed them, Lord. He ambushed them. Look here, the whole of that came upon it. Singers. They going out before the army. They just started singing unto the Lord.
You understand?
Let me tell y'all something. It ain't been posted yet. But we talked this last week in Mobile. I told the brother that this room that came in. They've been talking about praise. I said, brother, this is what we preached last week. It ain't been posted yet. It may be posted this weekend. This is what we talked last week. God been dealing with me about this. Do you understand? My God, man, we got to praise God.
But long as it's for my
in scripture where some in the scripture was murdering. Always murdering. God wasn't pleased with him. He wasn't pleased with him. You understand? You know what Paul said? I learned and learned to stay
with him. Thank you, Jesus.
Very weak. To be content. I know how to be amazed.
Thank you.
And I know how to die.
Thank you.
Whatever state I am, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Whatever situation is going on in your life, I promise you, if you look around, somebody's worth all. I was late getting here. We came straight here. And then check in at the hotel. Young folk, y'all know where we came from? From a funeral. One of the young brothers, one of the new brothers in the church in Mobile, son, passed. Died. Don't know all the details. But he was only 24 years old. For me to walk there today, and see this kid laying on the casket. You ought to want to praise God. Yeah. You ought to want to praise God. 24 years old. Stretched out. That's where me and some of the saints never talk today. You in the right place. I tell you right now, if you look back over your life, that should have been us. It should have been you. It should have been me. I wasn't always saved either, brother. I may not have your testimony, but I got mine. Brother Ken, I may not have yours, but I got mine. I can talk about this preacher before he became a preacher. Drunk and blind. Somebody said, what? That's right. Hidden trees. Got a car on the rise with it. See? They don't know to drive on the street. Oh, they back their street on a real street. Everybody's street. They didn't know that. But you know what, brother? God had mercy on us. God had mercy on us, brother. Brother Caleb talked about many of his peers and relatives coming up. I can say the same. I can say the same. My cousin David, we was like brothers, man. We was just like David and I was closer than my natural blood brother and I. David was my first cousin. David got married. David's first child. You know, back then, you know, we had God children and all that. I took his child as a double godchild. You know. David, all of us grew up together. We ran the street together. God stepped in and delivered me out of it. Let him in. He delivered me out of it. My brother, when he delivered me, I would talk to him. I would encourage him. David, when he would get in trouble, he would call me. And whatever he was going through, I would talk him through it. My wife, no, I would talk him through it. David married a young lady from her home. David, they was in Virginia. David had been in the military. And he had got out of the military, his wife was still in the military. I got home. David had shot his wife and was on the road. They said the police was looking for David, and they said he did it on a military base. The military police was looking for him as well. He had everybody on his way. My wife was there. I slept on the phone next to my bed, waiting on David to call. Because when David got in trouble, he called me. I'm waiting on David to call. David, please call me. So I can tell him to stop. Turn yourself in. 2 minutes looking for you. They don't get it. The next call
all of that up, baby was dead. We was like this. We was like this. The next call I got, my cousin, so close, we grew up together, is gone. I never got the call. And the sad thing about it, he took his own life. I share your pain, brother. I've been there. Do you understand? Men of mine that grew up with me, these brothers talked about drugs, how they had been delivered. Right now, he talked about your testimony, how I can help others. Let me tell you, many of them that grew up with me, they still struggle. Them that is not dead, they're strung out. And we come to the house of God and they're sitting in the middle of the night.
Some of y'all remember? My wife was pregnant with her. The doctor called us in,
said they had did a test and said she was going to be born retarded. So she was going to have Down syndrome. Said she would be mildly to severely retarded. They said, listen, Mr. Murray, y'all can go ahead and have an abortion. Because according to our test, she's going to be born retarded. That devil started talking. He said, you know you're a busy man. Do you really have time for a retarded child? Let me tell you what I talked back to him. I said, the word of God said, thou shalt not kill. And Jeremiah gave me some consolation. He said, before I fall, amen. Before you came forth from the room, I had already sacrificed. So he gave me consolation. God know I'm in the womb. And whatever the doctor sees, he's able to work it out. We put the other small kids on the stands. We had much to do. I had my babies raised. I was just like Jehovah. Do you understand? My God, I put my two boys and 200 babies at the time. They got me in the day. We gonna fast and pray for your unborn sister. That God will go in the womb and touch whatever needs to be touched and work it out. That went on for months.
A great king above all gods.
A great king above all gods. sit and look at one another.
Worship and bow down.
Let us sit and look at one another.
Worship and bow down.
I'm sophisticated, brother.
Worship and bow down.
Man, I'm sophisticated. I don't want nobody to see me break a sweat. What is that, John?
Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker.
Read us on.
For he is our God.
He is our God.
And we are the people of his pasture.
If you are sheep, you ought to cry out to the shepherd. Thank you, Jesus. Take your seats off. Thank God for Jesus.
That was wonderful, wasn't it?